special edition of Triad Today as we salute the North Carolina Education Lottery and all the fine work that it does. And you've been here to meet two very special guests. Alice Garland is now the executive director for the North Carolina Education Lottery. And next to her, somebody that's wearing two hats today. Pam Whitaker is a member of the North Carolina Lottery Commission. She is also president and founder of a company called Key Resources, headquartered in Greensboro. Welcome, ladies. How you doing?
Doing great.
The lottery is now 5 years old.
Correct.
So it's like happy anniversary. Okay, now we've gotten over the celebrations, but you've been there since the beginning. So sort of give me an assessment of what role the lottery has played in our economy and in our culture over those 5 years.
The lottery has had a pretty big impact. Folks think it's just what we return to education, which has been close to $1.6 billion,
yeah.
$1.56 billion to be precise. But we also give money to winners, as you've heard, and those folks take that money and they buy things in North Carolina.
Sure.
The retailers earn a commission. The average retailer in North Carolina earns $17,000 a year
from this.
Simply by selling lottery tickets.
I didn't realize that.
And then we hire companies that are North Carolina companies with North Carolina employees, and so there are a number of different ways that we are returning money to the North Carolina economy.
Pam, first of all, you're a member of the North Carolina Education Lottery Commission. What does that entail?
Commissioners are like trustees of the lottery. We ensure that the business of the lottery is run with fairness, integrity, and honesty.
What are those lottery dollars meant for education?
We pay for teachers in grades K through 3. We pay for four-year-olds to go through the More at Four program. We have doubled the number of four-year-olds that have been able to attend. We provide money to schools for school construction, and we fund college scholarships.
There's still some people that will say occasionally, you'll run into them, they say, well, I don't know if the state should be doing running a lottery. I don't know if my tax dollars should help the lottery. How do you respond to that? Clear up the misconception.
Well, first, it's not tax dollars. These are lottery dollars are dollars that individuals choose to spend. It's from their expendable funds. We operate totally off of revenues, so there are no tax dollars supporting what we do. I'd also like to say that we spend 1.2% of total revenue on salaries and benefits. So I think it's pretty unusual for a $1.4 billion business annually to spend only
just that amount on administration.
Right. So we are a pretty lean organization. We want to return as much money to education as is possible.
Which you're doing. And we have a website up here I want to get a plug in for, www.nc-educationlottery.org. I'm Jim Longworth. We'll see you next week.